Okay guys, this has been taking a long time to do, but I was waiting to go through all the records before I do this. Someone suggested once I was done going through them all, I should show what my favorite ones are. And that's been a while, that was Shimmy, so he said that. So, now here we go. I'm going to show you the two big ones that are my favorites first. The rest were just ABBA. There's a shit ton of ABBA. But I'm not going to say why there's a whole lot of ABBA. I really don't want to talk about that. But anyway, this is the first one. It's a bunch of sound effects. Two sides of it. My favorite one, without a doubt, has to be the second side, because it's got Model T sounds, car sounds, you know. Some of this is, meh. Music box, chain drive, overhead door. Some of this is, like, weirdly weird stuff. The probably best one is probably clock ticking time bomb effect. You play, put this on the record player, and you play this, and no one will know what the hell's going on. But this, without a doubt, is the best, if not one of the best big ones I have of them all, is Blondie, Heart of Glass. One side is the normal one, the other one's the instrumental, and it's extended. So, I wish I had a lot more kind of stuff like this, but I don't. So, now I'm going to show you 45s. These aren't in any order, except for the last thing I'm going to show you are actually the two I've been wanting. So, some of these is only for one side. There's only two sides. It's basically kind of like a single. I'm not that big into them, but there's another Aerosmith in here somewhere. Walk This Way. I know you can't see it because it's dark, but whatever. The other side has Come Together, so I'm guessing they did their own version of the Beatles song. I don't know. We have here Johnny Cash. I like Johnny Cash, but the other song is Folsom Prison Blues. So this is a really cool one, and I was arguing with someone. I think this is an actual signed one. I don't think it's one of those ones where they did it once and they master produced it. I doubt it, because why else would it be protected like this? Leslie Gore, It's My Party, I'm Gonna Cry If I Want To. And as you can see, it's been signed. I think this is a real one. There is ways to tell. I mean, I looked at it. You can see that it doesn't look like what was printed. It looked like it was written in ink. So I think it was actually done. This one's neat. I don't know why it was attached to a TV Guide thing, but it is. It's an extremely small record, and yes, it does work. It's Elvis. Let's see if it'll focus on it. Might have to do it myself. Whatever. Never before released live version. That's all right, Elvis Presley. What's on the other side? I want to know. Oh, it's nothing. It's a CD. It looks like a record, but it's actually a CD. Oh, here. I actually didn't take this out and look at it yet. So it's like a GameCube disc. I should put it in the GameCube just for laughs. So there you go. That's what it looks like. I'm gonna do the focus myself. See how it turns out. There you go. See, never before released live version. Elvis Presley. It looks like a record. I thought it was a real record. I probably should have known because it's clear stuff on the side. It's actually a disc, so it's a lot like the GameCube ones. Not for use of car stereos and certain CD players. Well, it'll work in a game. Well, you can stick it in a GameCube, it won't work, but you can put it in the computer. I'll leave the focus like this. The next one is Stevie Wonder Master Blaster. So, you know. All I like is it has the entire lyrics on the back. The best thing is probably this. If I can focus it correctly. So it says, lay flat on turntable, turn up volume, stand back, get it, because it says caution explosive. A little bit of humor. Woo! Next one's really unique. Okay, this one is only for one side. Oh, actually, it's this one. Bobby McFerrin, Don't Worry, Be Happy. Actually, on my Max Headroom DVDs, he does a live performance of that. This one, I'm going to admit, I only wanted to keep it because I'm a huge fan of Bruce Willis. I actually like his singing. Bruce Willis, respect yourself. And, of course, it has all the lyrics. What's on the other side, actually? Fun Time. It's a Motown one. Yeah, Respect Yourself. It's actually not that bad of a song. I think he sings pretty good. I mean, what's his name? Kevin Costner, he sung a few songs. Not all of these have a picture thing like that, though. There's one coming up, though. This one, without a doubt. On one side, it's Boston. One side is More Than a Feeling. And the other one is Long Time. So Free Play, Long Time. I have Free Play and Long Time on a different one somewhere in here. This one, I don't have to say anything about it, do I? Aha, Take On Me. I don't remember what's on the other side. Love Is a Reason. I only know one song by them, so. A lot of these people, they only had, like, one well-known song. Okay, here's an example of that. Devo. I like Devo Whip It, which is what this side is. Up here, it's very short. I like it when it says the time on it. I also didn't know it was Warner Brothers. But here's another song, Turn Around. I've never heard another song by Devo, unless it was Devo 2.0, which is completely different. It's actually not that bad. I like these RCA Victor ones. There's two here. Glenn Miller, I only show one. I like Glenn Miller, that kind of old jazz type stuff. So on this side, it's Moonlight Serenade I like the best. And on this one, it's Stardust. Although Tuxedo Junction is good too. Oh, you think that's something else? How about this one? I have Johann Strauss, Blue Danube Waltz. Now that's some good shit. On the big ones, I have over there two ones for the Scottish military or something like that, you know, bagpipes. I haven't played those yet. Ooh, that's going to be fun. And on this side, it's Bizet. Obviously, a lot of people probably wouldn't know who these are, but I do. It's Bizet, Les Arsenés, Suite number 2. Minuet and Faradale. Music Treasures Philharmonic Symphony Orchestra. I'll admit, I went to a place called Glassboro Fair Village, and I saw two, the same thing, they just had duplicates, of the Star Wars soundtrack for $5. I didn't get it. I feel stupid. So instead, I just only spent $1 and got Batman for VHS. Can't really complain. This one's only for one side. I never listened to the other side yet. Although I think I know who that is. It's that Chariots of Fire song, you know, the one they always play when people are running really slow. I have two Jerry Lewis. They're not together, though. There's probably more Jerry Lewis. There's a lot more. I'm not showing you. So, you know, I got, like, CCR in one of those boxes and a whole bunch of the Jacksons. I have a Weird Al song in there. Well, it's two on the side. For this one, for Jerry Lewis, I like Jerry Lewis overall, but it's a whole lot of shaking going on. We'll get to the other one. This one, definitely not for that side. It's this one, Apache. You know, jump on it. If anyone watches, or used to watch Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, at one point Carlton and Will were dancing to that song. It was really funny. Some of these I kept for specific reasons. Alright, this one's a shame. Of all these ones, they're all in perfect shape. The big ones, the little ones. This is the only one that's actually in bad shape for some reason. It sucks because I love this song. Duke of Earl. I actually have this on a CD. It's by Gene Chandler, as you can see. It's really messed up, but it works, kind of. I don't know if you can see it, but it's really fucked up. And it doesn't look like you can. This side's screwed up even more, but I have no idea. I never heard that song, so I ain't that interested in it. It's a shame, really. But out of thousands and thousands of 45 ones, and only one's really screwed up, that's not that bad. And now it doesn't want to go in. Hold on a second. Because I don't want it to get any worse than it already is. Well, this thing's pretty jacked up in itself. Okay, moving on. This one I haven't played yet because I'm basically saving it for the correct time of year. But it's Bing Crosby. Yes, you know it's Christmas music. One side is God Ye Rest, Merry Gentlemen. I have no idea who that is, what that one is. But it's this one, White Christmas. That's the one I'm interested in. Okay, this one I know is a little kid's music, but there's a reason I kept it. One side is Hokey Pokey, the other one's Bunny Hop. The reason I kept this is because it's exactly like the version that was in that one X-Files episode, so that's one of the reasons I wanted to keep it. Ray Anthony, I have no idea. I got another one that was in X-Files too, but I like the song anyway. This one is for How High the Moon. Most of you probably don't know what that song is. I was kind of disappointed of all these, I didn't find like a certain few. This one, I'm not big into Willie Nelson, but like this one song, On the Road Again. I have a couple more that has him in Waylon Jennings. I don't have any Waylon Jennings by himself, which I'm disappointed, so no, I don't have the Dukes of Hazzard theme. Okay, I have a lot of Bruce Springsteen here. I have even more I didn't show, but obviously it's like his well-known songs. One side's Pink Cadillac, the other one, which is probably my favorite song of his, is Dancing in the Dark. I just like Bruce Springsteen a lot. Glory Days and Stand on It. He's actually from my state, so Asbury Park in my state. And here we have this one, my hometown. That is his writing, what it looks like, too. And it's a picture of his hometown, the way it was back when he lived there. It's like a priest in that picture. Anyway, more Bruce Springsteen. War. I don't have to show you the record. You can just see what this is. War and Merry Christmas, Baby. I never understood how these little ones where it says B and W. I thought that meant black and white, but whatever. I've seen way too many old movies. Born in the USA and Shut Off the Light. I don't know that one by name. See, I know a lot of songs, but most of the time I just know them by who did it, not the song title itself. This one, I had to admit, I had to have it because I like Rodney Dangerfield, and it's just hilarious, and I love the picture. I was talking to someone, he says he knows it. One side is rapping Rodney, the other one's Fucili Funcella. I'm not Italian, so I can't say it. Look at that, he's got the fist thing going on, he's got a ghetto blaster. It's hilarious. And yes, it is just as hilarious as it seems. This one, I used to say this really long, wrong all the time until one day my mother corrected me. It's not Jay Gillis, it's Jay Giles. So one side is actually my favorite song by them, probably is one of them, it's their most well-known, Centerfold. Or actually, it's really called Angel is a Centerfold. But I actually think Rage in the Cage is probably a better song. So, whatever. This, I'm not that big into Black Sabbath, but I like Ozzy Osbourne, and this one he wrote all over. One side's Paranoid, the other one is The Wizard. I don't know what X means. Anyone who's a DJ can tell me what that means. I'd appreciate it. He wrote all over this one, too. It's a shame. This one's kind of screwed up, but not that bad. Steppenwolf, Magic Carpet Ride, hell yeah. And the other side is Born to Be Wild. I like Magic Carpet Ride better. And we're coming to the end of it, and then I'll show you my last two, which is the ones I actually was really interested in. Speed this up a little bit, because I'm going a little too slow. Jerry Lewis, Great Balls of Fire. On both sides. Same length. I don't know. I think one might be instrumental, I guess. Only Jimi Hendrix one out of all these thousand ones. Purple Haze and Foxy Lady. Luckily, Purple Haze is my favorite Jimi Hendrix song. So, yes, I like Jimi Hendrix. He's actually one of my favorites there is. This is when it was in X-Files 2, in Season 4, Home, when they're a bunch of inbred retards go to be a sheriff. Johnny Mathis' song, Wonderful Wonderful, is playing as they're driving around this beat-up white Cadillac, so I like Johnny Mathis anyway. Oh, here's one from Scarface, because I have it on a CD, but it's actually a remix, it's not the real version, so here you go. Debbie Harry, Rush Rush, and also Dance Dance Dance, which is actually my favorite song from that movie. I still would like to get the actual soundtrack for that movie on record, because that's the only way you get a real one. I have two Prince ones, or Prince and the Revolution, as it actually is called. Purple Rain, which is the one I'm interested in on that one. We have one that's not Prince. I don't even know how to say that or know him, but the one I wanted this for was because I like the movie Goodfellas, and it's in that Sunshine of Your Life by Cream. So there you go. We're almost at the end. More Prince, but not the Revolution. One side is just Prince, the other side is with the Revolution. When Doves Cry and Let's Go Crazy. No Little Red Corvette, unfortunately. This one I'm really happy to get because I love Ghostbusters, and they play this in the second one. Who is it? Jackie Wilson. Love Keeps Lifting Me Higher and Higher. I love that song. The other one, I have no damn idea what it is. I'm the one to do it, so it's for one song only. George Thorogood and the Destroyers, Bad to the Bone. Hell yeah. The other side is I Drink Alone, which rhymes. I have no idea what that song is. Haven't listened to it yet. I don't have to explain this one, do I? The Twist. What's on the other side? Pony Time. Sounds kind of funny. More Johnny Cash. Again, it's only for one side, really. And I just like Johnny Cash in general. I Walk the Line. I never saw the movie, but, you know, whatever. I like Kenny Loggins. Footloose on the other side, Swear Your Love. I don't know. And then we come to the final two. These are actually my two favorite songs. I'll show you the second one first. Not many people know who this is when I bring them up. Taco. You should know if you see the videos I like and all that kind of stuff and favorite. Because, like, every time I come across that I do, in case one goes away. RCA Victor one. Taco, Putting on the Ritz. Yes, I like if anyone knows of the Fred Astaire song, yes, I like that too, but I like this version the best. But the song that's on the other side is actually really good too. It's Living in My Dream World. These two are probably out of every one of these, even the big ones, are the ones I like the most, other than my Miami Vice soundtrack one. But this is my favorite song. This is one I was expecting I had to go to that place and buy, and they want $5 for it. I got this for free, and I was figuring, well, I came across one. I wonder if he'd have the other, and he did. I freaked the hell out, man. I screamed like no tomorrow when I just came across these. First off, the one that's on this one side is actually pretty good. Too many people. But this is my favorite song above all others in the whole world. Born to be a lot. Yeah. It's like the only song he's really known for. I would have loved it if I found Disco Queen, because that's actually a really rare one. So yeah, turn autofocus back on. So out of all the 45s and all the ones I got, these are my favorites. Sorry it took so long, but I wanted to show them. So, and I saved the best for last. So I wanted to put this up before I put WIS up. I have to render it out and all. That's going to take a while, so at least have something to watch. So thanks for watching, and I will see you next time. So now you know what my top two favorite songs are. Except for my third, you don't know what that is yet. I'll see you next time.